Welcome to my Let's Play of Iratus, Lord of the Dead. Basically you play as Iratus, the Necromancer, with all his minions, which you build over time, trying to fight your way from the mines, through the dwarf tunnels, through the mercenary barracks, up to the catacombs and then the cathedral. And I'm currently coming towards the end of the mercenary barracks, so I'm almost on my way to the catacombs. This is where I am. The exit is just there. I need to pick a squad, so I'll pick this squad. And we'll go have a nice little fight with a few mercenaries as I try and find my way out. Yep. As normal between episodes, I did level people up. I'm going to stress damage this... Oh, okay, I can't stress damage this person. Stress damage that person. Oh, okay, they're warded from stress damages. That's probably not a good start. Well, we've got other ward. And now let's... stress you that way. I'm in the mood to give people some stress. That's some serious stress. Okay, and apparently you're in the mood to shoot somebody. Can I hit you? Okay, I'm stress damaging this person apparently. I'm just in the mood to stress people at the moment.
This will be your end.
One of the reasons I want to do that is I want to turn people insane.
Now that's gonna leave a mark.
Because that will give me access to another type of minion. Oh, and I killed someone with stress. Stress is a great killer. Keep working on the stress. Oh, okay. Go. I thought I'd try a different attack. That one gets me who knows what. Let's go with a vengeance beam.
You will soon embrace your new existence.
Ooh, that stung a little. But I'm still working on stress. Okay, not with you, I'm not. I know you've got a block, but what the heck. I can't remember what the minion type is that I'll unlock if I stress everybody out. However. Really not that bothered what it is I'm going to get, I just want to stress people out. Sometimes you're just in the mood to hurt people with stress. What's this do? Okay, let's stress you out. It keeps buffing the gargoyle who I'm not actually attacking. Another one goes insane. Always nice. Okay, now I'll attack the gargoyle. Who's going to block me? There's a wonderful... thing called a spine box. Oh!
Have a little tingle up your spine.
Yes. I figured, what the heck? Let's go with a vengeance beam.
Terror will overflow.
Okay, now it's starting to become a little more crucial as actually start hurting people. Of course, you've got a block there, haven't you? Okay.
My kingdom comes.
Okay, I didn't manage to stress them to death, unfortunately. Ah, that one either ran away or there goes the spine bomb. Okay, time to finish this guy off. Oh, okay. He's got excessive armor on by the looks of it.
Don't know why. There's no sun up in the sky. Bony weather incoming.
I just figured I'd suck some of your health and give it to me.
Mop up the gore. I'd hate to see plants using it as fertilizer.
Well, that was a trying to outstress people type battle more than anything else. Possibly not the most successful way of doing that. Oh, just got to find another one of my wonderful...
Now I will make mortals tremble before me. Well, even more than previously.
Always looking for a one-time use thing. And I need to find whoever belongs in that slot, which I believe is you. And you can go over there. And you, and you can get healed. Okay, let's take... Take this squad out for a walk. I'll pick up a zombie. Okay, go over there. And onwards to battle. Right. This time, I am not planning on stressing people to death. If it happens, it happens. If it doesn't, c'est la vie. Ah! Oh, okay, I blocked that. They've got a scout at the back, do they?
Carve open their husks!
Nice of the barbarian to attack me.
Savor these last few heartbeats.
Yeehaw, one down. Doing the damage I can. OK. Okay, put two of my people to sleep. That's not very friendly. And that got you out of your stance. Oh, that drove somebody insane. That wasn't my intent. But I'm quite happy with the result if it works that way.
This never gets old.
My archer's taking a little bit of a beating. However, now this barbarian's turn to have the living daylights kicked out of it. Goodbye, barbarian.
A predictable outcome.
A predictable outcome, apparently, yes, but it was painful along the way too. So let me go get my people back. Then I can go shove you and you in there. Oh, I need another one-use artifact. Ah, okay. Now, which squad do I want to take? I'll take squad 2 with me to go for the boss fight. All your minions get 100% experience. We'll get 100% experience for Iratus. Okay, here we go with the wonders of the boss fight for the, what's that called? The Mercenary Barracks. Monster hunting is a pretty difficult job, chiefly due to the fact that the damn blighters are becoming quite rare in this day and age. The Monster Slayer has lived for so long that he has since switched to hunting more humanoid targets, as they are more plentiful and pay just as well. However, that does not mean that he has gotten rusty. Retirement may just be 100 years away now, but until then he can cut up abominations with the best of them. And it turns out the switch from slaying living, breathing humans to the undead is not a particularly difficult one. To battle! Okay, what the... He's the Monster Slayer. He's apparently just oiled his blade. That sounds like a euphemism where I come from. Source of magic, source of vigor, and source of wrath. Okay. Well, apparently I can hit anybody from here and ignores all blocks. So, ghoul, go get! Alrighty, I don't care what I hit. He's a bit tough, this guy. Alright, I'll tell you what, guys. Let's do
don't
that.
You know why? There's no sun up in the sky. Bony weather incoming.
He's gonna... Whoa. He's gonna be a little bit tough, this guy.
Your frail bodies fail you.
Definitely going to be a little bit tough. He's immune to that one. Okay, I think I might lose my archer around this time. Alright, let's...
Don't know why. There's no sun up in the sky. Bony weather incoming.
I have no idea if these things can actually be defeated, but they're just in the way. He gets a lot of attacks as well. There again, there is only him, so there to make it fair.
Hope there will still be enough left to reanimate.
Doing what I can with the capabilities my guys have.
Hope there will still be enough left to reanimate.
Now this guy is tough. Okay, what can we hit you with? Volley of spears. Target minion is it? No. All right, we'll hit you with a volley of spears.
Making a mass grave.
Kind of glad I've got this bone golem right about now. I say that, then he goes and misses. Okay, well...
Your frail bodies fail you.
I've got him down to half health. But it is definitely costing me. Okay. Well done. Hit the right personal thing.
Extinction of life.
Doing much damage right about now, but have a volley of spears. They're just gonna be there basically for the duration of this fight.
This will be your end.
I've almost got rid of this guy, this monster slayer. looking a little the worse for wear right about now. There we go, he's not doing my archer much good either. Really not doing my archer much good right about now.
Give them no mercy.
Yikes! He was a tough little soul. I got a level 18 brain and some quite a bit of other nice stuff out of that. But, oh boy, was that a challenge. Even more stuff. Well, let's... at the end of that. We'll choose that battle squad as it's not been beaten up. Head to the exit. Buried just beneath the surface of the catacombs, the dark secret of the Order. Here they train mages so that they can conduct sinister and dangerous experiments. It was always meant to stay a secret, but recent necromancer troubles have let knowledge of this place slip into the public. Making matters worse is that the mages were never expecting an attack from below, let alone that the attacker would be undead. The Grand Magister made his judgment. Instead of standing with the sorcerers, he sealed their tunnels and called back his paladins to the highest level in the order to prepare a defense. The spellcasters would fend for themselves in the face of Iratus, where they will either prevail or buy the Grand Magister some time to muster his veteran knights for a decisive battle against the forces of liberated evil. So, looks like I'm going to be fighting mages. However, not right now, because I need to recover from that battle. As always, I just want to find a disposable artifact.
It embellishes my undead features, no?
And I'm curious how close I am. 3,107 points before I get a Blood Phantasm. And 21 more insanities before I get a Shade. I've got to turn 3 enemies into vampires to get vampires. Not quite sure how that works. Okay. Well, that is where I'm going to end this episode. That was a tough little fight. As always, I hope you enjoyed to one degree or another, and hopefully I'll see you down the road for more of Iratus, Lord of the Dead, in the near future. Cheerio!